then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. Then later on he understood that I'm only not free, but my brothers and my sisters are also not free. Okay, they are not enjoying their life, he thought. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, reduced. Not only my freedom was stopped, not only my freedom was reduced, but my brothers and sisters' freedom is also been reduced. But the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That is when I joined the African National Congress. At that time he joined the National Congress. African National Congress he joined at that time. Then what happened? And that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people. That time really he started to hunger for the freedom of the people. Not only he thought about like selfish, he did not think selfishly that time. He started to think about the people. That is a change we can see when he joined in the African National Congress. It was his desire, it was his wish for the freedom of his people to live their lives with the dignity and self-respect that animated his life. So he wanted his people to live happily in dignity and self-respect. That transformed, that changed a frightened young man into a bold one. That really whatever he thought in his mind that his people have to live in dignity and self-respect, that time he lost that frightened, whatever the fear he lost in him, and he became really bold when he joined in the African National Congress. Okay, and that drew a law-abiding attorney. Attorney is nothing but a lawyer, a law-abiding who doesn't obey the rules and regulations. So that lawyer, he became a criminal. Law-abiding attorney, sorry. So here, who abide the rules and regulations, a good lawyer, he changed to criminal here. Okay, and that turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home. So a family-loving husband has changed to without a home, a man living alone without home and family. That forced a life-loving man to live like a monk who loved his life. Now he became a monk. I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedoms I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. So he thought that when my people are not free, when my people are not enjoying their freedom and life, how can I enjoy? Started to think Nelson Mandela. Freedom is indivisible. The chains on any one of my people were the chains on all of them. So he's telling that the chains on any one of the people will be the chains on all of them. And the chains on all of my people were the chains on me. He feels like the chains are on his people. He feels like he is chained. Okay? So that much attachment he is having towards his people. I knew that the oppressor, who is this here oppressor? A person who tortured and oppressed a person who is being tortured. Okay, so I knew that oppressor must be liberated just as surely as oppressed. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. A man who takes away other man's freedom is treated as a prisoner of hatred. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. So a man who takes away other's freedom is just like a narrow-minded person. And he is telling that I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom. We are not free when we take away some other's freedom. Yes or no? Yeah. Just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. So he will not be free. We will not be free when the freedom is taken away from us. In the same way, if we take some other's freedom, how can we be free? How can we be happy? That's really true. Wonderful words are said by Nelson Mandela. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. So the oppressor and the oppressed and the oppressor both are being robbed of their humanity. Our humanity we lose if we take away others' freedom, or if we lose our freedom. both are same. Okay, we are being robbed our humanity. That you should know. That is the lesson which is given beautifully by Nelson Mandela. And what are all the things he taught to us is his autobiography. Okay, first thing he taught for us is about his childhood. Second one, as a student, what was the thing he have done? When as a student he really thought very selfishly that he want only for him the freedom. Okay, and as a student he thought, and as a young man he thought only for earning for his keep, for his marriage, how his family must be and all. In that way he thought. But when he joined the African National Congress, he really changed drastically, and he just started to think only for the society. Yes, his feelings only for the society he thought. And that was really, we need to think today, okay? Why are we to take away others? Who are we? Okay, we have to think first. We have to question to ourselves that, who are we to take away others' freedom? Okay, that is a question you have to keep to yourself. And really, if you are really enjoying the freedom, then you are really happy and great person. So that is a wonderful story which is given by Nelson Mandela, who was born on July 18th, 1918. He was the first South African president to be elected in a fully representative democratic election. And he trained as an attorney. He helped form from the Youth League of the African National Congress in 1944. In 1961, he abandoned peaceful protest and became head of the ANC's new military wing. And he sentenced to life imprisonment in the year 1964. And Mandela came to symbolize black political aspirations and was named head of the ANC after his release on February 11, 1919. He and F.W. de Klerk shared the Nobel Peace Prize for negotiating South Africa's peaceful transition to the multiracial democracy. After the ANC victory in the April 1994 elections, Mandela worked to ease the racial tensions and court foreign investment and provide services to the victims of apartheid. So that was the story, children. I hope you have understood. Thank you, children.